Hey guys, it's Clout. I'm going to teach you how to use S-Shake and Ikawa's Shake macro in Davinci Resolve. We're going to transform this clip from this to this in only a couple of minutes. Let's get straight into it. So I divided this into sections so this is a little bit more understandable. First, we have the clip and the way that's twixt. Then we have the main juice of the operation, which is the shake. Then you have the movement, so a slide, transition, any type of motion. And then we have the extra stuff that helps add to the impact of the shake. So this would be defocus gamma, or you might add some blur or some glow or extra one framers, anything to really help the shake be more impactful. Although S-Shake is officially available in DaVinci Resolve, if you have the plugin, download it from my server. I do want to go over different options that are natively available in DaVinci Resolve and might be less laggy for you. The first one I'm going to go over is Ikawa X-Shake. I nicknamed it to Best Shake right here. And the other one is S-Shake Lite. Both of these shakes will be available for download in the description. If you're coming from After Effects, I'm going to try to explain the way this shake works in terms of S-Shake. If you want to change the randomness of the shake, you would have to press the reseed button right here. And you can't really control exactly how random it is, you just have to press the button and work with what you have. And smoothness controls the frequency of the shake. And amplitude will change the intensity of the shake, just like how it is in S-Shake. S-Shake Lite is the same thing, but it comes with this phase control for every single parameter right here of the shake. In my opinion, I prefer Ikawa X-Shake way more, and it just feels way more responsive. Have your own preference. If you want higher frequency shakes or twitch shakes, for example, all you have to do is just turn down overall smoothness. Everything is at default settings, and all I did was turn down overall smoothness to 0.2. If I wanted more of a twitch shake, I would turn up motion blur, and I would put down overall smoothness to literally the lowest it can go. There you go. If we look at the frames, that literally looks like a twitch shake right there. Anyways, let's start with the shake. I start with the transform node, and I just zoom in a little bit. Either 1.2 to 1.5 looks pretty nice. And as long as you have this graph right here, you just have to go down and drag this in. It will look pretty good regardless. Next, we have the shake. The first thing I did was keyframe amplitude. And if you want to graph amplitude, it's a little bit weird, but you have to find this maximum checkbox right here and the graph will come up just fine. And this is the graph that I used. When I'm changing the values, I hold control so I have a more precise selection of them. So for example, for overall smoothness, the default's 1.24, but I lowered that down to 1.072. And these little minute changes actually make a big difference in the end result. So just be sure to hold control when you're making changes. And these are the rest of the values that I used. Now for the next clip, this is a little bit more complicated because it actually has more movement in it. It has a couple of frames of offset, and it also has a zoom in, some directional blur, and a little bit of color correction. So the first shake that I use is paired with an out graph. And this is what an out graph looks like. And I never go above 0.2. So I go 0.192, and then it goes all the way down to not quite zero, just 0.0025. Everything else is actually default settings, except for the smoothness right here. I just cranked it up a little bit to 1.8. And then the next shake that transitions to the next clip starts towards the middle. I did this because the graphs, when they overlap, kind of makes things look more smooth. So that's what I did. And this time it's not default settings. I cranked up the Y amp and the X amp, and I turned up X smoothness. Again, with the overall amplitude, I started from zero, then I went all the way to 1.6. So quick recap of what you have to do. Once you import your clip and twix it, do the time remap, all that good stuff. Then you have to zoom in a little bit, then zoom out, and then you have to keyframe the shake along with the zoom in. And once you have your keyframes in place, play with the values of the shake until you get something that you like. And that's about it. That's all you have to do to get a good shake in DaVinci Resolve.